Welcome guys, today's class we'll go to discuss about respiration. Respiration which includes two processes, that is breathing and respiration. Right. We'll see the definition of the breathing first of all. Breathing is a process which includes inhalation and exhalation. So what is meant by inhalation and what is meant by exhalation? Inhalation is a process of taking gases into the lungs, and exhalation is a process of releasing the gases into the external atmosphere, right? So in the breathing, lungs are helping. So most of the organisms are breathing through the lungs, and if the breathing takes place through the lungs and then respiration is occurring through the lungs, then that kind of respiration is called as pulmonary respiration. And apart from this, lungs do any other kind of respiration you can see, that is if you see cutaneous respiration. What is meant by cutaneous respiration? Cutaneous respiration is one type of respiration where the breathing takes place through the skin. If the breathing takes place with the help of skin, that kind of respiration you can see as a cutaneous respiration, and most of the time you can see in the frogs. And you know, the lungs will be useful for the respiration, and that is called as a pulmonary respiration, right? And respiration itself have differentiated into two types, that is aerobic respiration and another one is a anaerobic respiration. What do you mean by aerobic respiration? What do you mean by anaerobic respiration? You see, whenever we are talking about aerobic and anaerobic, there is a clear-cut word, if you can observe that A. In that, air means specially that oxygen, that is O2, right? In a one type of respiration where the oxygen is involved, that kind of respiration we call that aerobic respiration. In aerobic respiration, oxygen inhale and carbon dioxide exhale. That type of respiration called as aerobic respiration, where there is a no involvement of oxygen. No oxygen. There is no need of oxygen. There is no involvement of oxygen in a respiration, and that type of respiration we are calling it as a anaerobic respiration. Clear? So where we can take example, aerobic respiration, you can take example in human beings and even like, you know, many other kind of organisms. But where anaerobic respiration, yeast and some other kind of microorganism, right, they perform anaerobic respiration and they produce alcohol and energy. If you talk about energy, the aerobic respiration, anaerobic respiration, when you compare, aerobic respiration releases high amount of energy when compared with the anaerobic, right? Glucose was created, that glucose need to be break down, right, and release energy. The glucose need to be break down and that need to produce energy. For that, what we need? We need oxygen, right? So oxygen plus glucose, that will break down the glucose and that will give energy. Apart from that, like, you know, energy, other byproducts also come, like water and carbon dioxide. But main aim is to release energy, right? For that we need oxygen in aerobic. In anaerobic there is no need of oxygen, but still the energy will be created, and even carbon ethanol, that means alcohol, will be produces, where you see in the anaerobic. Those is a 6-carbon molecule. So how you 6-carbon molecule, I am saying that you should know the structure of the glucose, then you will understand what is mean by 6-carbon molecule. Let's say 6-carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6-carbon, it is like a backbone, right? If you take the glucose for chemical formula like C6H12O6, this is what the glucose formula, and C6H12O6, you see now C6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? Later on H12, and which means like, you know, 12 molecules of hydrogen and 6 molecules of oxygen. We'll see now first. Right, so this is what the structural formula of the glucose, C6H12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, right, 12 hydrogen and O6, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, clear? So this is now glucose, that is 6-carbon molecule containing, and that glucose is further breaking down into pyruvate. The pyruvate is 3-carbon molecule, 3-carbon containing molecule. So 3-carbon means one glucose contains 6-carbon, then it will further break down into pyruvate, that pyruvate which contains only 3-carbons, means the glucose is broken down into two parts, that is, this is a 1-pyruvate, another is another pyruvate, for our understanding in this, okay. And later on, the pyruvate, you remember this, everything is happening in the cytoplasm. What is cytoplasm? You should know, like cytoplasm, which present a jelly-like substance in the cell, that will present in both plant cell and animal cell, right? So let's say the last, just now we discussed aerobic and anaerobic also. If you remember, aerobic means what? Aerobic means presence of oxygen, right? So I'll take it here, presence of oxygen. In presence of oxygen, pyruvate molecule further break down and gives energy plus carbon dioxide plus water. So energy it will release in the form of ATP, adenosine triphosphate, right, and carbon dioxide, which is a exhaled air, what will release, and water, even moist, this will be comes out in the form of water vapors, moisture. When you breathe outside, that air also containing the moisture, right? That is what. So remember, energy, carbon dioxide and water. This is when the presence of oxygen, and that's why I said like aerobic respiration, which is a presence of oxygen. Next thing you see, a lack of oxygen. Presence of oxygen means oxygen is there, but lack of oxygen means the required amount of oxygen was not there. So that is what lack of oxygen. Lack of oxygen, then energy will release, and later on lactic acid. So energy releases and lactic acid also releases. Clear? So here lactic acid, which is 3 carbon containing molecule, so 3 carbon containing molecule, right? So lactic acid will release, and that is what, there is no releasing of any kind of carbon dioxide and water, right? And in this lack of oxygen, when it will be happen is when the insufficient amount of oxygen is in your body, but still you need energy. In that case, the oxygen debit will form, and in that particular situation, the glucose will break down. In the absence of oxygen, that leads to production of lactic acid and energy. The lactic acid will be released inside your muscle, so that the muscle will get pain. These are called muscle cramps, right? Later on, this is all about absence of O2, which included also, like, you know, anaerobic respiration. So in anaerobic respiration, you know already alcohol will form. Before that, you have to understand energy will release. Later on, carbon dioxide and ethanol, it is also like, you know, ethanol or alcohol. Let's see, guys, what is happening here is the glucose is breaking down into pyruvate, that is a 3 carbon molecule. You know, this is one pyruvate, this is another pyruvate, for our understanding, 3 carbon molecule containing. And later on, the one pyruvate will break down into energy, carbon dioxide, water, when in the presence of oxygen, that is aerobic respiration. And this, when the lack of oxygen, it is comes under aerobic only, but in that particular place we don't have the oxygen, right? And later on, that this situation will happen in the debit of oxygen. And later again, when the oxygen you will take, the muscle cramps and everything will be gone, and you don't get the pain again. Okay, the oxygen will replace this all lactic acid, so that you won't get the pain. So lack of oxygen, that will release energy and lactic acid. Okay, next, absence of oxygen, this will comes under the aerobic respiration. In this, energy will be releases, carbon dioxide also releases, and ethanol also. Ethanol is a 2 carbon molecule, 2 carbon molecule containing product. It means like a product, that is where is the one more carbon, means you can say like carbon dioxide comes out, right? So that is how the remaining carbon molecule is coming out in the form of carbon dioxide, right? So this is how one glucose molecule is further separated into pyruvate, and pyruvate is breaking down in the presence of oxygen, in the lack of oxygen, in the absence of oxygen. Clear? What is the difference between these? Means aerobic respiration, which releases more energy, anaerobic respiration less energy when compared with the aerobic respiration. And what, in aerobic respiration, water releases, in anaerobic respiration no water get released, right? And what happen here, this happens in the mitochondria, and this is happening in the cytoplasm, right? Mitochondria, and this anaerobic respiration is happening in a cytoplasm. Clear? These are a few differences, right? And next, you see how these glucose is breaking down, how the oxygen, like we discussed, like oxygen, like how the oxygen is entering into our body, in what form, and how that is transported from one place to another place. It means like one part of the body to the other parts of the body. So where the energy is needed, there the oxygen need to be supplied. So how the oxygen is being supplied up to there, that we will discuss now. When you see the respiration in a human being, that includes the breathing and cellular respiration. First we see the process of breathing, and then we will see how the gases are exchanging and how the gases are transporting from the lungs level to the blood, right? And wherever the energy need to be released over there. First of all, the human nozzle passage, which collects the gases, gases which includes, like, you know, oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, helium, and other kind of whatever the other gases are there, all gases I'm talking about, right? So these you can call it as a mixture of gases you are inhaling, right? And when it is inhaling, there are some changes that takes place in your lungs. First of all, you see the lungs are a sponge tissues, which are like similar like sponge which you need to rub the board, what type of, like, you know, sponge squeezy, right? So that type of a sponge type of cells your lungs are made up of. And below that you are having a muscle called as diaphragm, right? So basically you are having a two lungs, one pair of lungs it means, and that is, like, you know, protected or situated in the thoracic cavity. When you see the left side heart is giving a space for the heart over here, this cavity, right? And this is what you can see little broad, and over here the right side one, which is little small when compared with the left side one, because of the below this right side lung you are having liver. For that it has to give the space for the liver, that's what it becomes little small, right? It becomes little small. It is narrow, but it is broad, it is narrow, okay, it is short, it is lengthy, like that, you remember. And now we see the inhalation process. What happens is, when inhalation process, naturally your lungs are not having any kind of a contract nature and relaxed nature, okay? So if it doesn't have a contract nature, then how the exhalation is happening, how the inhalation is happening? In that case, you know, the diaphragm is a one type of a muscle. What it will do is, it have the natural contraction and natural relaxation nature. So when the muscle of the diaphragm is relaxed, when the muscle of diaphragm is relaxed, it will push the lungs, it will push the lungs into thoracic cavity upwards. So that what happens is, when it increases, it will decreases, right? Its sizes decreases, it squeezes it. So that what happens, the air present in the lungs comes out. This is called expiration or exhalation, right? So the gas which comes out from the lungs, right? When the diaphragm was relaxing, in that case the lungs are contracting, and the which is the gas present in the lungs is coming out of the lung. That is what called as expiration or exhalation. And when the diaphragm is contracting, because it is becoming into small, when it becoming into small or, like, you know, contracting, in that time the lungs are getting its natural size. When it is natural size, it means you can say it is relaxed, it is expanding. When it is expanding, naturally it collects the gases from the outside to lungs. This process we are calling it as a inspiration or inhalation, right? Exhalation, you know now, and inspiration or inhalation. When inhalation time, what is happening? The diaphragm is get contracting, so that the lungs are getting relaxed. In that case, the gas present outside are entering into the lungs. This is what up to clear, But how the gas is coming? Any like you know, there are different parts are present, like a nozzle passage and mouth cavity, pharynx, larynx, and what do you say, like a trachea and bronchi and bronchioles. These all types are there. By passing these, the air is entering into the closed sac-like structure called as alveoli. So we'll see first of all, the mixture of gases are entering into the nose, right, by the nozzle passage. So in the nozzle passage, you can see a small amount of hair will be present, so that will restrict the entry of dust particles into your windpipe, right? So whenever the passage of gases passed from the nozzle passage, that will now enter into the pharynx region. Okay, in the pharynx region, you can see we discussed in a nutrition, I said like, you know, a flap like muscle was present, that is called as a epiglottis. I said, what is the function of epiglottis? Epiglottis function is to separate the food pipe and windpipe. So it will regulate the entry of food into the food pipe and wind into the windpipe respectively. So in that case, where the epiglottis is present, it is present in the pharynx region, right? And later on, see the larynx. After passing the air from the pharynx, it will enter into the larynx region. So larynx region, where you can see vocal cord is present here, where you can see over here in this region, the vocal cord. What is the function of vocal cord? Vocal cord, whenever you are exhaling the air, the air will comes into the vocal cord, and that will become into a frequency noise, and that noise will module into a voice, right? So we are controlling our noise by using our tongue, movement of tongue. With this, we are making a sound. That is only we are calling as a voice, right? So normally in the larynx region, you are having a vocal cord, and the vocal cord is helping in the making of sound, and that sound only we are calling as a voice, right? Simply you can say a voice box, right? Later on, the gas will pass into the trachea. So that is like, you know, rings of cartilage, so where the smooth muscle, smooth bone, you can call it as, right? So that cartilage is internally covered with a mucus. So whichever, like, you know, dust particles or any other kind of microgerms will be entered, that will be sticked to the walls of the trachea, and that mucus will be exhaled outside, right? Or split outside. Next thing, that trachea will be further differentiated into two separate parts, that is two branches, and that is called as a bronchi. So each bronchi will enter into the individual lung. This is one lung, this is other lung, right? So this bronchi is entering into the right side, and this is entering into left side. This is clear. And this bronchi is further divided into small branches, that is called as a bronchioles. So these bronchioles are the further division of bronchi. Okay, so where the bronchi is further divided into bronchioles, and that is spread all over the lung, so that every space, every corner of the lungs is having a connection with the, like, you know, air pipes, right? And these bronchioli is further opening into alveoli. Alveoli is like, you know, it is a cavity, or like, you know, it is a room, it's closed part, closed area where it is connected with a blood vessel. Let's see, I'm just taking a small portion over here, and I'm drawing over here. So this is one alveoli I'm taking, right? This is a blood vessel, right? So let's say these are RBCs. You know that RBC is a blood cell which helpful for the transportation of gases such as carbon dioxide and oxygen, right? And RBC is in a red in color because of the hemoglobin. If you talk about a hemoglobin, hemoglobin is a pigment, and the hemoglobin is only having the nature to give red color this RBC, right? And the another important function is the hemoglobin is having a such a kind of bond that will contact with the oxygen and carbon dioxide, okay, and that will carry from one place to another place, such as like, you know, from the lungs to the other part of the body, right? So let's say this is a RBC, which means like already the hemoglobin is there, right? So let's see, guys. Inhalation takes place so that the mixture of gases was entered nasal passage and pharynx, larynx, trachea, and bronchi and bronchioli and alveoli. So now you see the mixture of gases are entered. So the mixture of gases are entered. Let's see here, oxygen, carbon dioxide. I'll write about the concentration. Oxygen is 21%, right? Carbon dioxide is 0.034, like that, right? So oxygen, carbon dioxide, and other gases also there. Let's see, like nitrogen is 78%, right? And others are 7%, 0.07% or 0.7%, right? And the oxygen carbon dioxide which is entered into the alveoli, right, the concentration you know already. And when you see the exhaled air, the concentration will be changes. When you see the exhaled air, oxygen concentration will become into 16 and the carbon dioxide concentration will become into 5, right? And nitrogen will become into 78, it won't change. And the other gases, let's say like a 0.7, there is no changes in other gases also. But when you see over here in alveoli, what is happening, what phenomenon is taking place is, when the gas is inhaled, the concentration is, the concentration of oxygen and the carbon dioxide is oxygen is more and carbon dioxide is less. But in an exhale, the oxygen concentration is decreasing and carbon dioxide concentration is increasing. Why it is happening? Because of, you know that the blood cells are carrying deoxygenated blood now, which means like, you know, from the body parts to the lung, which blood is coming, that is deoxygenated. What do you mean by deoxygenated? The blood which doesn't contain oxygen, instead of oxygen, if it is contained carbon dioxide, that type of blood we are calling it as a deoxygenated blood, and this is that blood, deoxygenated blood. Clear? So let's see, boys. This is what, like, you know, you inhaled, this is inhaled, and this is exhaled, right? So let's say the passage of air is like this, blood vessel. So the blood is coming in this direction into the alveoli, and there are small passage, the connections are there, that is called as a capillaries, right? Very micro type of blood vessels we are calling as capillaries, right? It's very smaller, very narrow than the our veins, okay? So the blood containing carbon dioxide now, CO2, because it is a deoxygenated blood, and that carbon dioxide is more in the blood vessel, and that is less in the alveoli, because of in the alveoli, you know, the carbon dioxide concentration is only 0.34, right? And in the blood vessel, it is more when compared with the alveoli. So from the higher concentration to lower concentration, carbon dioxide comes out, right? From the higher concentration from the blood into the alveoli, the higher concentration, from the higher concentration to lower concentration, you know, this process is called as a diffusion is a process or phenomenon where the movement of molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration. This is called diffusion, and that process only working over here. From higher concentration to lower concentration, the molecule is moving. That's fine. And now, what is happening here is, when compare the oxygen concentration, the inhaled gas is having 21% oxygen, but in the blood vessel there is no oxygen because it is a deoxygenated, right? And that carbon dioxide also left. Then this blood doesn't contain oxygen, doesn't contain carbon dioxide. So higher concentration of oxygen is present in the alveoli, and that alveoli containing oxygen is now entering into the blood vessel through the process of same diffusion, from higher concentration to lower concentration, right? Like this, the movement of molecules or the blood exchanges the gases takes place. Clear? And what happened after this? Once the gases got collected by the blood, this blood now enter into the, like, you know, heart, right, through the pulmonary vein, and then it will circulate through all over the body through the arteries. Clear? And wherever the oxygen is needed to break down the glucose and to release the energy, in that particular place the oxygen will be released by the blood cells, and the released carbon dioxide or the produced carbon dioxide will be again carried from that particular place, and that will be again released in the lungs. The similar process, carbon dioxide collects from that place and releases in the lungs, which is in the alveoli place, and later on it collects the oxygen and it will move to the heart, from the heart different parts of the body. This phenomenon, which, like, you know, respiration includes. So respiration means what first? Respiration is a process where the oxygen need to break down the molecule which is a carbohydrate and releases the energy. Okay, for the sake of growth and development, we need energy, right? And if you see the activities, that is 6.4, where you have seen, like, you know, how to confirm that yes, we are releasing carbon dioxide only and we are taking oxygen only. In this case, you know, the particular gases have their nature, their, like, you know, particular nature. So for example, if you take oxygen can, like, you know, help the flame to burn with a more intensively. And when you see the carbon dioxide will decreases the flame intensity. In the same time, you see the another nature of the carbon dioxide is, it will react with the lime water, and that will convert the lime water into milky white precipitate. We'll see the activity 6.4, what you are discussing is, in a 6.4 activity, what we are having is, we have to confirm that whether really the exhaled air is containing carbon dioxide or not. For that, you have taken the two test tubes, right? Test tube A, test tube B. Test tube A and test tube B both are filled with the equal amount of lime water. Equal amount of lime water. But thing is, in a test tube A, we release the air by using the pichkari, right? We release the air into the lime water by using the pichkari, and in another test tube B, we blow the air by using, like, you know, with our mouth, and we exhale the gases directly into the test tube B. So what kind of changes you can find is, there is no change takes place in the test tube A because of, there is no carbon dioxide present in it, because the pichkari is not converting only, like, you know, it's not containing only carbon dioxide. But when you see the test tube B, we are blowing the air through the straw, so definitely the exhaled air going, and so that is converting the lime water into milky white precipitate. That is giving the clear cut indication, the exhaled air containing CO2, because you know that CO2 can only convert the lime water into milky white precipitate. In a 6.5 activity, what you are seeing is, in 6.5 activity, you have to take one test tube and add the fruit juice in it, right? And add little amount of yeast. You know the yeast, which is an aerobic respiration, it will show, and it will break down the glucose or carbohydrates present in the juice, and that will break, that will give the, yes, exactly, alcohol. That is ethanol it will produce. But thing is, it should not be like, you know, contact with the air, so that we have to close the mouth of the test tube by using the, like, you know, a tight cotton plug, or else like a cord you can use, so that it will be closed tightly, so that it may not have a contact with the external surface, and there is no exchange of gases takes place. In these conditions, the yeast will start breaking down the carbohydrate present in it. Carbohydrate, there is another question. Sir, this is a fruit juice, then which kind of carbohydrate present? You have a glucose, starch, lactose, maltose, fructose. So most of the fruits are containing the carbohydrate called as fructose. Okay, and some are even containing, like, you know, starch also. But when you see in the, most of the juices are containing the fructose, because most sweetest carbohydrate is a fructose. So that fructose is further breaking down to form alcohol, and this process only we call it as a fermentation. What is fermentation? Fermentation is a process where, through the following anaerobic respiration, creation of alcohol. Activity 6.6 was there. So in activity 6.6, what we are discussing is how the aquatic animals exchange the gases. The aquatic animals exchange the gases, which gases are present in the dissolved form in a water. So even the oxygen is present in the dissolved water, also in the dissolved form. That oxygen is called as dissolved oxygen concentration. Okay, so dissolved oxygen concentration. So that particular oxygen will be absorbed by the aquatic animals, especially if you take the fish. The fish will collect the oxygen by using the gills, right? First of all, it will collect the water into the mouth, and it will flush into the gills. In that meanwhile, what happens is the gills will filter the water, and it will collect the oxygen, and the remaining water will be flushed out from the operculum. What is operculum? Operculum is an area like behind the eyes. Let's see, so this is what fish, and where you see the respiration in it. First, the oxygen is present in the water, that is called as dissolved oxygen concentration, and that water will be taken into mouth and then flushed into the gills. So in the gills, what is happening? The gills will collect the oxygen concentration, and remaining water will be flushed outside, and that water will comes out through the operculum. Operculum is this, like, you know, bony like structure where present behind the eyes, right? And that will be release the water into outer surface, right? This is what the function of operculum, and how the gases will be exchanged. And whenever the gases releases, no, like the water releases out from the operculum, that water even consists of carbon dioxide. I hope this will be helpful for you. Thank you.